and welcome back to my channel. So today it's time for yet another Amazon haul featuring some miscellaneous items but mostly pantry. So it's going to be a lot of stuff to get through. If you're confused about what Amazon India Pantry is, I made a video when I first shopped from Pantry. It's a little bit different from the regular section of Amazon. And the reason I'm publishing this video today, you guys, on the 1st of May, is that Amazon has super value days for the first 3 dates of every single month. If you're buying Amazon Pantry stuff, you really save and you get further cashbacks and stuff. If you shop for your groceries and your household essentials on the first 3 dates of the month, so I decided that I will do one pantry haul at least every month, and I'll make it available for you on the 1st of the month so that you guys can see what I have picked up. And in case you would like to buy the things, today is a good day to buy them. You can maximize your savings because I make these hauls not only to show you what I bought but to help you shop smarter. So if this is your first time watching one of my Amazon haul videos, I'd just like to let you know that I list all the products that I'm going to show you in the description bar below this video. So just click show more, there'll be a list of all the products that I bought and also links so that wherever in India you are, you can go and purchase these same products for yourself if you want. And I also put out many more Amazon haul videos. I've been doing it for a long time and I do it very often. So if you like these type of videos, then make sure to check out the other ones on my channel. Feel free to subscribe to my channel if you like what you see here. Yes, my cats also make regular appearances. So in case you didn't know, you're just going to have to get used to it. So when I'm opening up the very first box, so basically this is a set of Indian cup noodles. I've talked about these cup noodles in some previous hauls. They're by Nissin brand, and I've also talked about how noodle companies in India don't really make that many non-veg flavors, but Nissin has been releasing some really nice flavors recently. Once I saw that this set was available, I picked it up. It's all non-veg, so there's 2 mutton rogan josh curry, 2 rich seafood curry, and 2 spicy chunky chicken. I think all 3 of these are new flavors. So you get it in this cool looking pack which actually has a handle, and it's super nice. It's a pack of 6, and it's also like you save some money because Amazon is the best. There are always discounts. This is really random and it's different from the rest of the video, but I thought some of you all might like to see it. This is nicely wrapped in like plastic and stuff, so it's proving to be a bit of a challenge to open. Okay, you really need to be careful around scissors. These are dangerous, so please give me some space. This is a small piece of decor for your home, and I think that ladies will especially like this, but of course men need it too. It's a small stand mirror from Amazon Basics that you can put on any table in your bathroom or in your bedroom. That will help you get ready. I remember when I just started YouTube a few years ago, I was looking really hard to find a stand mirror like this, and it's very cool because one side is also magnified so you can see every pore. And no one really wants to see every pore because it's not flattering, but it's really good if you're doing makeup or something, or if you're shaving, you just want to be precise. I really liked how minimal the design is. It's just like sort of a brushed aluminium type of finish. You can keep watches, rings, whatever small jewelry in these stacks, and you can just use this to get ready. Best thing about it is super affordable compared to all mirrors like this that I've seen. Like with this nice classy finish. I already have one mirror like this, but I thought I could just buy another one, why not? The mirror that you just saw was from Amazon Basics, which is Amazon's own brand, and they make really good quality stuff at really nice prices. If you guys are interested in more Amazon Basics things for your home, I've done a previous haul that showed a lot of home things and some travel things, all from Amazon Basics, so you can watch that by pressing the little I in the upper right corner of this video. Now we're going to move on to the section that I think you all like the best. This is the pantry section. One thing that I really like about Amazon Pantry is that you get all the things that you ordered together. So if you order 15 things, they'll come in one box instead of coming in 10 different boxes. It's really convenient and also eco-friendly because they're not using too many resources on packing and stuff. And the boxes are really filled. And because I'm a Prime member, I get this so quickly. Like if I ordered it one day, it will come the next day. Like before the next day ends, in the evening or something, I'll get everything. And I really love how good Amazon is at delivering things quickly. As usual, they put in some of these bags to protect your stuff. The first thing I have in here is a pack of 6 Paperboat Amrus juices. I really like when Paperboat used to have their 1-liter juice packs. I don't know if they've discontinued it, but for a long time I have not seen it on Amazon. So instead I bought these individual packets. It's a set of 6. I really hope the 1-liter packs come back, but until then I will be drinking this. They make the best quality Amrus mango based juice compared to all the other brands out there, whether it's like Mangola or Slice or anyone. Paper Boats is so thick and so good. So if you guys like thick mango pulpy juices, you will like it. The next thing that I bought is from Cadbury Bonvita. In my last haul video, I asked you guys to tell me what you like eating or like by itself that you shouldn't actually eat, but you guys like eating it. And so many commented that you all like to have Bonvita powder. When I was on the website again, I looked and I found this Bonvita biscuits, which I've never tried before. These are mainly made for kids, but they're supposed to be healthy. They don't have cream in them. They're just like Bonvita flavored biscuits. So I thought they'd be good for a snack. One packet of Madhur 1 kg sugar. We use this mostly for tea. We don't use that much sugar otherwise, but with our tea consumption, a lot of this gets consumed. This is kind of another repeat from the previous Amazon haul also. I really like the Pringles that I got. And first I thought that they came really broken, but the chips are mostly intact inside and you get quite a lot. So I'm a huge fan, and this time I decided to try out another flavor, and the zingy tomato variant had good reviews, so I figured that I will try it out. This is really nice, very crunchy, fresh. And it's got that very distinctive Pringles flavor with a little bit of tomato also, which, yeah, I like it. It's good. I honestly feel like you can't go wrong with Pringles. The green color sour cream and onion is my favorite flavor, but really I've liked every single Pringle flavor I've tasted, like without exception. They're all very good. The last thing that was in that big box is another box. This one has Bauli Moonfills, which I've also shown in multiple hauls before. This is like a sort of a slightly sweet snack that you can have for like breakfast, you can have for dessert, or just like any time of the day. It's kind of like something like a cake, but not super sweet. It's very light and it's got some cream flavoring inside. So it's available in a bunch of different flavors. Orange and strawberry are a little bit more jam based, but I prefer the cream ones, which are the chocolate flavors and the vanilla flavors. And I can never have enough of these. I especially like having them in the morning. So I thought that I should just buy like a whole box again. I've bought boxes once before. And I was going to buy a second box also of vanilla, but I said I'll do that next time. So this time I've just bought chocolate flavor. Says so on the box that this contains 20 packets each, and again you get it at a pretty nice discount. So I was very happy to buy it, and I am going to be enjoying all of these Moonfills. I might share some of them, but largely they're mostly for me. And now before we go on to the last pantry box, I realized that I did not show you what was in this box. It's nothing glamorous at all. It's just something that we probably all need in our house. actually purchased a broom on Amazon. I never thought that this day would come. I'm sure even my mom never guessed that there would be a day that we would buy a broom online. But we all need it, right? This is supposed to be a different kind of broom. It's a zero dust broom. Most of the regular brooms that we Indians use at home, it leaves a lot of dust and husk behind. So this is supposed to be plastic fibers. Now I know that regular brooms are probably a little bit more environmentally friendly, and these being plastic fibers, they are not going to be as biodegradable. But the idea of brooms not shedding a lot was something that appealed to me. And also this broom is washable, which you can do with a regular broom. And you can use it for both dry and wet areas. This is the first time that I'm buying this Milton broom. So honestly, even I'm kind of curious to see what it looks like. Oh, it's kind of cute. So though it's plastic, they've kind of made it look like a regular broom. But then it has these tears like on a dress. I guess this will help you pick up the dust. And this is not supposed to shed at all from the first use, even if you're rough with it. I think it looks kind of cool, but I have to wait and see how this really... But I have to wait and see how this performs. And I'll write down below whether I liked it or I didn't like it. And now we're on to the final pantry box. I think there are going to be a good amount of things in here. This was the heaviest box. There's a lot of different foodstuffs in here. Some snacks, some instant food, and all of that. And I better warn you guys right away that all of these are not very healthy snacks, because some of you all love to comment and say that I'm buying unhealthy things. Guys, I know that they're unhealthy, but it's totally fine if you like the food and you eat it in moderation and you have a good amount of physical activity, okay? So I just like buying salty snacks and chips a lot, and I don't think I will be stopping that anytime soon. But please know that these snacks are not everything that I eat in a day. I have healthy stuff also. So the first thing that I purchased is a shampoo. I have a lot of shampoos at home, many which are much better than this, but I ran out of dandruff shampoo. And now with the humid weather and the summer in Mumbai, I know that I'm going to be needing to use dandruff shampoo at least once in a while in my routine. I never use this all the time because dandruff shampoos can be a little harsh, but just sometimes when your scalp feels itchy or whatever, you need to use this. So I bought this pretty big size of Head & Shoulders Cool Menthol, which is supposed to be cooling and energizing. And they have bigger sizes, they have smaller sizes, but I thought this one was right for me now. I think it's going to last like at least through the summer. Oh, the next thing that I purchased is a tea. It's by this brand called, I don't know how this is pronounced because it's a foreign brand, whether it's Pukka or Pukka or Pukka, I don't know, P-U-K-K-A. I probably should have checked online. But this is the vanilla chai. It's a caffeine-free organic lift flushed with cinnamon and warmth. I can totally smell the cinnamon. It smells very, very strong. This brand is a little premium compared to most of the brands that are available in India. But I saw it at a good discount and I picked up one because I know that vanilla chai sounds like a pleasing flavor. I bought a packet of Doritos nacho cheese flavored chips. I'm a little sad because it looks like the air has gone out of this, so it may not stay very fresh for long. But if I eat it soon, it will be fine. I mainly buy these so my mom can make homemade nachos, and she makes really good nachos. And if you guys want to see the nacho recipe, you guys should go and watch my Goa vlog. I have many Goa vlogs, but go watch the one which I link right now, because we made nachos many times in that vlog. So just saying. One packet of Haldiram's Bundi. This is just a salty snack that's very tasty. And you can have it on its own or you can make raita out of it with dahi. Both ways are really good. And I'm kind of obsessed with Bundi at the moment, to be honest. Bought one packet of Sunfeast Palm Light Digestive Biscuits with oat fiber. I think I pick this up every single time. I don't personally enjoy it myself, but I give it to my parents. It's a healthy biscuit during tea time. And this also has almonds or something. it's pretty cool. Another packet of Haldiram snacks. This is Khatta Meetha. It's a chuda. It's just a dry snack that you can eat anytime. And Khatta Meetha literally means sour and sweet. Here it says sweet and salty. So it's a snack that's made from rice flakes and besan, which is gram flour. It is deep fried, so it's probably not like very healthy, but it's not very unhealthy either. It's just a traditional Indian snack. And I enjoy having this. I bought some Act 2 cheese bakes. I buy this once in a while because my dad really likes it. So the last time I think I bought him so many that he got a little fed up. But now a few days ago, he was asking me for them. So I picked these up. This is a buy one get one free pack. It's quite nice and economical. There's probably more of these also. Yeah, one more pack at least. And here another flavor of Pringles. This is my all-time favorite, sour cream and onion flavor. Even my mom really enjoys this flavor, and I know that I'm going to like enjoy having this. Now I bought something a little bit silly. And it's just this dabba of Hajmola candy. So this is Maha candy in two flavors. The flavors are Albela Aam and Chulbuli Imli. So Aam is mango and Imli is tamarind. This is like a sweet and sour candy. And you save some money when you buy this dabba. And you also get like 10 candies worth 10 rupees free. That means each individual one is worth 1 rupee. We used to have a lot of candies like this when I was a kid, but we haven't recently. When I saw this available online, I just got excited and the reviews were mostly good, so I just bought it. And even my mom, who's helping me film this video, is smiling right now. I didn't even realize it, but I bought two Doritos, not one. I don't know why both the packets are a little bit fuss this time. It seems like they're slightly deflated and that is not very good. But otherwise, I like buying Doritos. And if you're going to consume them within the next week or two, there's no issue. Only if you keep them, they'll become soggy fast. So here are some more random snacks that I bought. This is some brand called Puff Wafflets. So I don't know why they call these wafflets. They just look like little wafer biscuits to me. But they looked tempting. There were a few different flavors available, so I thought I'd try the Belgian chocolate flavor. It's a really small size pack, but it was also fairly cheap, so it's fun to try something different sometimes. Another snack I purchased is by this brand called Too Yum, and this is supposed to be a sort of snack that's tasty and healthy, zero trans fat, baked not fried, and it has proteins. These are veggie sticks. So this is literally made with some parts real carrot, which is nice because carrot's not my favorite vegetable on its own. But yeah, the flavor is cheese and herbs and it looks good. And if it's really healthy and it's tasty, that's going to be a good thing. Some instant noodles in here from one of the most beloved brands. I purchased some Maggi masala. And in my last video, some of you also mentioned that you like eating the masala packets from this noodles, and I just wanted to say, even I really love it. The masala is so tasty. Even if I don't enjoy the texture of Maggi noodles that much, the masala is really awesome. So I can totally relate. And I bought one smaller packet of their chicken noodles. For some reason, these chicken noodles are really difficult to find. Like even when you go to your local grocery store, they only have masala and atta, and you don't get chicken. So I was like, I want some chicken also. There's a third packet of this, guys. I did not realize, but I bought three packets in total. I bought two packets of this that I had my eyes on for a while. And I really like making khichdi at home. It's one of my favorite comfort foods, and my mom mostly makes it with rice, masoor dal, I think. And sometimes she puts some moong also, and she tries to make it healthy as possible by making the rice less and keeping the dals more. But I saw this mix online. It's from Tata Sampann. It's this new Tata brand of like masalas and pulses, which is endorsed by Chef Sanjeev Kapoor. This made me most interested because this is a multi-grain khichdi mix, and it has 6 grains in here. It's got rice, rajgira, moong dal, ragi, bajra, and jowar. I don't know what the proportions are going to be of each, but this is just supposed to be easy. Like you can directly put this mix in a pressure cooker and make the whole thing. And then you can do a tadka. We like doing a tadka for flavor, just to add some little bit of spice into the khichdi. But if you're eating this when you're sick, you should probably keep it as bland as possible. I was quite excited to try these out because they were out of stock for a while, and I really hope that I like them. I bought one packet of Fortune Besan. I already mentioned earlier in this video that it is chana dal. It's made of gram flour, and it's also called chane ka atta. Just a few weeks ago, I realized for the first time in my life that besan and chane ka atta are the same thing, because at home we always say chane ka atta. And you can make a lot of different snacks and foods with this. It's really tasty. My mom makes good bhajiyas at home with this, with either onion or potato. And you can also make like this really nice bindi snack with chane ka atta. We were running low and I needed to pick some up. Another packet of veggie sticks. Lots of multiples in here. For some reason, I also purchased a loose cup noodle and I forgot about it. So there are really quite a lot of cup noodles in this haul. I bought a lot of this MTR 3-minute mix khatta meetha poha. I'm obsessed with this, guys, because you get like the home style poha. And it's very, very quick. You don't have to take much trouble. I love eating this for breakfast. If you watch the vlogs on my channel, you'll have already seen me make this. And sometimes just as a snack during the day, it's very nice. And when you want that homestyle poha without too much of effort, you guys have got to try this. I'm really enjoying it right now. So, bought a bunch of them because they're really nice. We are down to the last few things for sure. I just picked up two individual soups from Knorr's. One is the Chicken Delight soup and one is the Thai vegetable soup. I couldn't remember if we've tried the Thai vegetable flavor before, but I like Thai flavors and that's why I decided to try it. Final things in here are just a lot of different sauces and spreads from Cremica and Viva brands. So from Cremica, I picked up two spreads. One is a sandwich spread piri piri. This is going to be like a little bit spicy but a little bit creamy. And one is the sandwich spread mint. I was hoping that this is similar to the spread that's inside of McDonald's Chicken McGrill burgers. If you don't know, in Mumbai, they have discontinued those burgers and I kind of miss them. More than the chicken patty, I really like that minty mayo that used to be there inside, and I got nostalgic for it. So I hope that this will taste a little bit similar to that. Another one from Cremica, I bought their mayo with egg, because most of the brands make eggless mayo nowadays, which kind of makes me wonder. One way, it's really good that these brands are incorporating people's diet restrictions into their products, but at the same time, I'm very skeptical of mayonnaise not having egg, because it's a main ingredient of mayonnaise to have egg in it. I was just happy to get egg mayo. I purchased this Viva white pasta dressing because I usually make a good pasta sauce from scratch, but I thought that maybe next time I could make it from scratch but also add some of this for flavor, and I'll check it out and see how good it is. Final two from Viva, one is garlic mayonnaise and another one is classic mayonnaise which has egg in it. We go through a lot of mayonnaise at home. Finally, there's a sauce. Oh, I forgot. Also from Viva. It's the teriyaki stir fry sauce. Teriyaki is a really popular Japanese flavor. You can use this sauce with vegetables, but especially with meat, it tastes best with meat, like red meat or even chicken. And I wanted to give this a try and see if it's better than the other brands out there. I've tried a few things from Viva though. They're really quite nice. Many of these are first time buys though, so I will report back on them sometime. And with that, we've finished everything. We've emptied out all of the boxes. I have talked far too long. I hope you guys enjoyed this Amazon haul. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. And if you decide to buy any of these things I've bought or anything else, the links are in the description. Happy shopping. Bye.